So here we have a shell and tube heat exchanger. It has one shell pass and 15 tube passes. So we'll write that the number of tube passes is equal to 15. We have hot water on the tube side, so that's the hot fluid, and it heats oil on the shell side, which is the cold fluid. So the length per pass of this tube is 3 meters, and it has a diameter of 25 millimeters. So our water, which is our hot fluid, it enters, so THI is equal to 85 degrees C. Its mass flow rate is equal to 0.15 kilograms per second, and TH out is equal to 20 degrees Celsius. So we have our cold inlet temperature, which is the oil, which is 5 degrees C, and the outlet temperature is 30 degrees C. And what we're looking for is the average convective heat transfer coefficient for the outer tube surface. And what we're given is this inner heat transfer coefficient of 3600 watts per meter squared K. So how are we going to find our H sub O? Well, we're going to use the overall heat transfer coefficient, which is U. And we know that UA is equal to the sum of the thermal resistances to the minus 1, which is equal to 1 over H outside times the area plus 1 over H inside times the area raised to the minus 1. So if we can find UA, we can find our H0. So we're going to use the Ntu effectiveness method because by definition, the Ntu, which is the number of transfer units, is equal to UA, which is what we're looking for, divided by the minimum heat capacity rate. To find Ntu, we consult a table which gives Ntu as a function of the heat capacity rate ratio and the effectiveness. So the appropriate equations are as follows. Let's start with this C sub R, this heat capacity ratio, and this is equal to the heat capacity rate that's the minimum divided by the one that's the maximum, where this heat capacity rate is equal to the mass flow rate times the heat capacity. So we can find the C for the water, because that's equal to 0.15 kilograms per second multiplied by its heat capacity, 4184 joules per kilogram Kelvin. And so our heat capacity rate of the water is 627.6 watts per Kelvin. So how do we find the heat capacity rate for the oil? We don't have a mass flow rate. We don't have a heat capacity. But what we do have is enough information to find the heat transfer rate, which is equal to a heat capacity rate times a change in temperature. And we have it for the water. So this is equal to 627.6 watts per K times the difference in temperatures, which is 85 minus 20. This is in degrees Celsius. Our Q dot is equal to 40,794 watts. We assume a well-insulated system. Heat exchangers should be well-insulated. So the amount of the heat transfer provided by the water is the amount gained by the oil. So that means our Q dot is going to be equal to the heat capacity rate of the oil times the change in temperature of that oil, which is 30 minus 5 degrees Celsius. And so that heat capacity rate is equal to 1632 watts per K. So looking at this, it's clear that this one is the minimum heat capacity rate. This one is the maximum heat capacity rate. And so from that, we can find that ratio that we need, which is equal to 0.38. So the next thing we're going to need to find is this epsilon, which is the effectiveness, and that's equal to the heat transfer rate divided by the maximum heat transfer rate. So we have our Q dot. Now we have to find our Q max, and that's equal to the minimum heat capacity rate times the inlet temperature of the hot stream minus the inlet temperature of the cold stream. And so when we write that out, that's going to be equal to 627.6 watts per K Kelvin, 85 degrees minus 5 degrees, and our Q max is equal to 50,208 watts. So if we divide the Q that we found here by our Q max, we find that our effectiveness is equal to 0.81. And now what we do is we put everything back into these messy equations to solve for our big E, and from that to solve from our NTU. So calculating this, we find that our big E is equal to 1.005, and our NTU is equal to 6.85. And now we can go back to use that to find our UA. So our UA is equal to this NTU, 6.85, times our minimum heat capacity rate, 627.6 watts per Kelvin, and that equals 4,298.2 watts per K. And so now we go back to where we use that to find right here our outside convective heat transfer coefficient. So we can write that 1 over UA is equal to 1 over the outside heat transfer coefficient times A plus 1 over the inside heat transfer coefficient times A, and the areas cancel out. So we're left with 1 over U is equal to 1 over HO plus 1 over HI. Now we're going to calculate that area using the 0.025 meter diameter, and we come up with a total area of 3.53 meters squared. So from that, we can get our U, which is equal to the 4298.2 watts per K divided by 3.53 meters squared, and our overall heat transfer coefficient is 1216 watts per meter squared K. So our 1 over U is equal to 0.008 meters squared Kelvin per watts, which leaves us with an outside heat transfer coefficient of 1,836.6 watts per meter squared K.